We have no bread.
Of course you have no bread.
What do you wish?
It's not what I wish, it's what you wish. Nothing cooking in there now, is there?
The old enchantress went on to tell the couple that she had placed a spell on their house.
What spell?
In the past, when you were no more than a babe, your father brought his young wife and you to this cottage. They were a handsome couple, but not handsome neighbors. You see, your mother was a child and had developed an unusual appetite. She took one look at my beautiful garden, and she told your father that what she wanted more than anything in the world was greens, greens, and nothing but greens. Parsley, peppers, cabbages, and celery, asparagus, and watercress, and fiddleberries, and lettuce. He said, all right, but it wasn't right, because I caught him in the autumn in my garden one night. He was robbing me, raping me, rooting in my yarrow, raining my arugula, and ripping up the rampy in my champion, my favorite. I should have laid a spell on him right there. Could have turned him into stone, or a dog, or a chair, or a slip. Not return, however, I said, fair is fair. You can let me have the baby that your wife will bear. And we'll call it Square.
I had a brother.
No. But you had a sister.
But the witch refused to tell him any more of his sister, not even that her name was Rapunzel. He went on.
I thought I'd been more reasonable. And that we all might live happily ever after. But how was I to know what your father had also hidden in his pocket? You see, when I had inherited that garden, my mother warned me that I would be punished if ever I were to lose any of the beans.
Beans!
Special beans. I let him go. I didn't know he'd stolen my beans. I was watching him crawl back over the wall, and then bang, crash, and the lightning flash, and well, that's another story. Anyway, at last the big day came, and I made my claim. Oh, let me go with your baby! And shrieked and screeched, but I did, and I hit her where she'll never be reached. Your father cried, and your mother died, but for extra measure, I admit it was a pleasure. I said, sorry, I'm still not qualified, and I laid a little spell. You too, son. That your family tree would always be a barren one. So, there's no more fuss, there's no more scenes, and my garden thrives. You should see my nectar rings, but I'm telling you the same, I tell kings and queens. Don't ever, ever. Never mess around with my greens, especially the beans.
Now listen to me, Jack. Lead Milky White to market and fetch the best price you can. Take no less than £5. Are you listening to me?
Yes.
Now how much are you to ask?
No more than five.
Less than five.
Jack, Jack, go to the wood and bring me back one, the cow is white as milk, two, the cape is red, blunder, three, the hair as yellow as corn, four, the slipper as pure as gold. Ring before the chime of midnight, in 3 days' time, and you shall have, I guarantee, a child as perfect as child can be.
Go to the wedding!
Lady!
Wait, I'm very quick. Now may I go to the festival?
The festival? Starting with this, starting with clothes, mantles, or one thing.
In the red cape!
Forget about the little girl! And get the cape!
You frightened me!
That's the cape. Get it?
am I supposed to get it?
Go up to the little thing and you take it.
I can't just take a cloak from a little girl. Why don't you take it?
I might, but I can't.
A golden cow.
World, and so shut her within a doorless tower that lay deep within the forest. And when the old enchantress paid a visit, she called forth
Rapunzel. Rapunzel. Hair to me.
Rapunzel. Rapunzel, what a strange name. Strange. Oh, but beautiful. Fit for a prince. Tomorrow, before that horrible witch arrives, I shall stand before her window and ask her to let her hair down to me.
Hello there, little one.
Hello.
Sometimes the things you most wish for are not to be touched.
The harder to get, the better to have. Agreed? Agreed.
Never wear mauve at a ball.
Or pink. Or open your mouth.
Look!
The difference between a cow and a bean is a bean can begin an adventure.
Slotted spoons don't hold much soup.
Closer to the family, the closer to the wine.
One midnight song.
The mouth of a wolf is not the end of the world.
A servant is not just a dog to a prince.
Opportunity is not a lengthy business.
You may know what you need, but to get what you want, better see that you keep what you have.
One midnight gone.
Sometimes
the
village goes
one midnight gone.
One midnight gone.
One midnight gone. Into the woods.
There are giants in the sky. There are big, tall, terrible giants in the sky. When you're way up high and you look below at the world you left and the things you know, little more than a glance is enough to show you just how small you are.
Oh, I don't want to touch that! Have you no sense? Before tomorrow's midnight, deliver the items or you'll wish you never thought to have a child.
Oh. I don't like that woman.
What are you doing?
I'm here to make amends. I want you to stay out of this, old man. I'm here to see your wishes granted.
You've caused enough trouble. Stay out of my path.
Getting us good. You see, I'm a man much more than I knew.
take care, take me, let me, and despair.
Should listen. What were you not to do? Children must see and learn. Why could you not obey? Children should listen. What have I been to you? What would you have me be? Handsome like a tree. Company enough.
I am no longer a child. I wish to see the world.
Don't you know what's out there in the world? Someone has to shield you from the world. Stay with me. Princes wait there in the world. It's true. Princes, yes, but wolves and humans too. Stay at home. I am home. Who out there could love you more than I? What out there that I cannot supply? World.
protection, and yet you disobeyed me.
No!
Why did you not tell me you had a visitor? I will not share you, but I will show you a world you have never seen!
When is a white cow not a white cow?
I don't know! Leave me alone!
Haven't I left you alone long enough?
Your questions make no sense, old man. Go away.
In need of another cow?
What a beautiful cake!
Stay away from my cake, or I'll slice you into 1,000 bits.
I don't want it. I was just admiring it.
My granny made this for me from a wolf that attacked us. And I got to skin the animal. And best of all, she gave me this beautiful knife for protection.
Well, look what I have. A hen that lays golden eggs.
I don't believe that egg came from that hen. Where did you get that egg?
I stole this from the kingdom of the giant up there. And if you think this is something, you should see the golden harp the giant has. It plays the most beautiful tunes without your even having to touch it.
Of course it does. Why don't you go up to the kingdom right now and bring it back and show me?
I could.
You could not.
I could.
You could not, Mr. Liar.
I am not a liar. I'll get that harp. You'll see.
After having cast out Rapunzel to a remote desert, the witch returned to take the prince by surprise. And as he leapt from the tower, the thorns into which he fell pierced his eyes and blinded him. As for Cinderella, she returned from her final visit to the festival.
He's a very smart prince. He's a prince who prepares. Knowing this time I'd run from him, he spread pitch on the stairs. I was caught unawares. And I thought, well, he cares. This is more than just malice. Better stop and take stock while you're standing here stuck on the steps of the palace. You think, what do you want? You think, make a decision. Why not stay and be caught? You think, well, if the robber would be his response. But then what if he knew who you were when you know that you're not what he thinks that he wants? And then what if you are? What a prince would envision. Although how can you know who you are till you know what you want, what you don't? So then which do you pick? Where you're safe, out of sight, and yourself, but where everything's wrong. Or where everything's right, and you know that you'll never be long. And whichever you pick, do it quick, cause you're starting to stick to the steps of the palace. It's your first big decision. The choice isn't easy to make. To arrive at a ball, it's exciting and all. Once you're there, though, it's scary. And it's fun to deceive when you know you can leave, but you have to be wary. There's a lot that's at stake, but you've stalled long enough because you're still standing stuck in the stuff on the steps. Better run along home and avoid the collision. Even though they don't care, you'll be better off there where there's nothing to choose, so there's nothing to lose. So you pry up your shoes. And from out of the blue, and without any guide, you know what your decision is, which is not to decide. You'll just leave him a clue, for example, a shoe, and then see what he'll do. Now it's he and not you who is stuck with a shoe, in a stew, in the goo. And you've learned something too, something you never knew, on the steps of the palace.
Yes?
That cow doesn't look as white as milk to me.
Yes, she is. Yes, she
is. That cow's been covered with dough.
Well, we had a cow as white as milk. Honestly, we did.
Where is she?
She's dead. We thought you would prefer a live one. So.
Well, of course I prefer a live one. So forget the dead one. I'll bring her back to life.
But you could do that?
No!
There you are! I've been worried sick.
Mother, look, the most beautiful harp.
You've stolen too much.
You could have been killed coming down that plant.
It's too heavy. What's happening?
Ah! You'll be white. Now I have two friends, a cow and a horse.
Quiet!
Feed the objects to the cow.
What? You heard me. Feed them to the cow. Pero vet.
I'll do it. She'll only milk for me.
Oh, quickly. Hurry, please.
Squeeze, pal.
Oh,
wrong ingredients. Forget about a child.
No! You wait! We followed your instructions. The cow's as white as milk!
Yes.
The cape as red as blood!
Yes!
The flipper as pure as
gold! Yes.
Before I compared the hair to this ear of corn!
I pulled that hair from a maiden in a tower!
You what? What were you doing there?
Nothing.
I touched that hair! Don't you understand? I cannot have touched the ingredients!
The corn! The corn! What? The silky hair of the corn! Pull it from the ear and feed it to the cow!
Set the
workable
man before the lash! Smoke of midnight, or your son will be the last of your flesh and blood.
Son, please, not now.
Yes, meet your
father. Could that be you? I thought you died.
I didn't want to run away from you, son, but...
It's working.
She's milking.
I don't understand.
Not now. Into the cup.
Look at this.
She's milking.
Mother, she's...
I think it's working.
You can keep it.
She's yours.
When did you have a child? You promised me a child. What time is it here?
I don't know.
You said I could have a child. What are you doing? Where are you going?
Mother!
Can always repair.
Mother!
What's happening?
And so the mysterious old man died, having helped end the curse on his house. For the baker, there would be no reconciliation with his father, and he and his wife, bewildered, returned home. And the witch, who had been punished with age and ugliness that fateful night when her beans had been stolen and the lightning flashed, was now returned to her former state of youth and beauty. And Milky White, after a night of severe indigestion, was reunited with the now wealthy Jack. As for the prince, he began his search for the foot to fit the golden slipper. When he came to Cinderella's house, Cinderella's stepmother took... To which the woman replied,
"No, only a little stunted kitchen wench, which his late wife left behind. But she's much too dirty. She cannot show herself."
"I insist."
And when Cinderella presented herself and tried on the blood-soaked slipper, it fit like a glove.
"This is the true bride.
I always wanted a son."
And much to the dismay of the stepmother and her daughters, the prince took Cinderella on his horse and rode off.
"No love at all within my shoe. This is the proper bride for you. Fit to attend a prince."
And finally, as for Rapunzel, she bore twins and lived impoverished in the desert until the day her prince, wandering aimlessly, heard a voice so familiar that he went towards it. And when he approached, Rapunzel, overjoyed at seeing him again, fell into his arms weeping. Two of her tears wetted his eyes, and their touch restored his vision.
I was going to come fetch you as soon as you had learned your lesson. Who are you? Surely you remember.
Mother?
This is who I truly am. Come with me, child. We can be happy as we once were.
No, she will not go with you.
You let her speak for herself.
Come with me. You are the only family I know. Come. You leave me no choice.
No, no.
As is often the way in these tales, in exchange for her youth and beauty, the witch lost her powers. When the wedding with the prince was celebrated, Lucinda and Florinda attended, wishing to gain favor with Cinderella and share in her good fortune. But as the sisters stood by the blessed couple, pigeons swooped down upon them and poked out their eyes and punished them with blindness.
I see your prince has found you.
Yes.
Thank you for the slipper.
I didn't think I'd wed a prince.
I didn't think I'd ever find you.
I didn't think I could be so happy.
And it came to pass that all that seemed wrong was now right. The kingdoms were filled with joy, and all who deserved to were certain to live a long and happy life ever after.
Ever after.
Journey over, all is mended, and it's not just for today, but tomorrow and extended ever after.
Ever after.
All the curses have been ended. The reverse is wiped away. All is tenderness and laughter for forever after.
Happy now and happy hence and happy ever after.
There were dangers and confusion, and the path would often swerve.
We did not.
There were constant disillusions, but they never lost their nerve.
And they reached the right conclusion.
And we got what we deserved.
Not a sigh and not a sorrow, tenderness and laughter.
I was
haughty,
I was smug, we were happy. It was fun.
We were blind and we went into the woods to get our wish, and now we're really blind.
I had everything but beauty, I had power, and a daughter like a flower, and a
tower. Then I went into the woods to get my wish, and now I'm ordinary.
We're unworthy, we're unhappy now, unhappy hence as well as ever after. Have we used our common sense, been worthy of our discontent to be happy? And forever, you must see your wish come true.
Don't be careful, don't be clever, when you see your wish pursue.
They were all content.
I never thought
thought I'd wed a prince.
I never thought I'd find perfection.
I never thought I could be so happy. Not an unhappy moment since.
Not a conceivable objection.
I never thought we'd have a baby.
I never thought I could
be so happy. Happy now, happy hence, happy ever after.
We're so happy, you're so happy. Just
not one round.
Oh, my goodness.
Are you all right?
I think so.
And the baby?
Yes, no, he's just fine, he's fine. Are you all right? Phil,
have you done this to our house?
Always thinking of yourself. Look at my garden.
Oh, what of your garden?
Look!
Destroyed. What has happened?
I was thrown to the ground. I saw nothing.
Oh, what could do such a thing?
An earthquake.
An earthquake? My garden has been trampled. Bones or footprints.
Who could do such a thing?
Anything that could leave a footprint that large is no good.
Do you think it was a bear?
Bears are sweet. Besides, you ever see a bear with 44 feet?
A dragon?
No scorch marks. Usually they're neat.
Magical.
Imaginary.
Griffin?
Extinct.
Giant.
Possible. Very, very possible.
A giant.
Well, maybe we should tell someone. Who are you going to tell?
The royal family, of course.
The royal family, of course.
I wouldn't count on that family to snuff out a rat. With a giant, we'll all have to go to battle. A giant's the worst. A giant has a brain. Hard to outwit a giant. A giant is just like us, only bigger. Much, much bigger. So big that we are just an expendable bug beneath its foot. Boom! And
moving.
And so the baker proceeded to the castle, but not before visiting Jack and his mother.
Oh, nothing. You just locked me in a tower without company for 14 years, then blinded my prince and banished me to a desert where I had little to eat, and again no company, and then bore twins. Because of the way you treated me, I'll never, never be happy.
I was only trying to be a good mother.
Oh.
Rapunzel, stay with me. There's a giant about.
Brother. Surprise. Brother. How good to see you. What brings you to the wood today? I am investigating news of a giant. You investigating news of a giant? My father would not even do that. That is business for your steward or less. Well, what brings you into the wood? My Rapunzel has run off. She has been subject to hysterical fits of crying. Moods that no soul could predict. I know not what to do. What a pity. And Cinderella? She remains well. Does she? Now, brother, do tell me what you're really doing here. I, in a tower like yours was, but higher, a beauty asleep. All round the tower, a thicket of briar, 100 feet deep. Agony, no frustration more keen, when the one thing you want is a thing that you've not even seen. I found a casket entirely of glass. No, it's unbreakable. Inside, don't ask it, a maiden, alas, just as unwakeable, what unmistakable agony is the way always barred.
She has skin white as snow.
Did you learn her name?
No, there's a dwarf standing guard.
Agony, such that princes must weep. Always enthralled, most to anything, almost or something asleep. If it were not for the thicket,
the thicket's no trick, is it thicket's
the thickest?
The quickest is picket apart with a stick.
Yes, but even one prick, it's my thing about blood.
Well, it's sick.
It's no sicker than your thing with dwarves.
Dwarves,
dwarves. Dwarves are very upsetting. Not forgetting the tasks unachievable, mountains unscalable, if it's conceivable but unavailable. Agony, misery, not to know what you miss. While they lie there for years,
and you cry on their fears,
what unbearable bliss. Agony that can cut like a knife. Ah, well, back to my wife.
Rapunzel, I must be off. Godspeed to you, villain.
Godspeed.
Are you certain this is the right direction?
Went up and down.
Perhaps you forgot the way.
The path is straight.
Was straight. There is no path.
Where's the stream? Where's the lily pond? Where's Granny?
Calm down. Just calm down, please. Maybe she can help.
Yeah. We'll just have to find Granny without the path.
But Mother Warby can never stray from the path.
The path is straight from you.
Wait. That looks familiar. See in the distance, three oak trees.
Yes, I recognize that.
Who might that be?
That's the steward in the royal family. What brings you into the woods?
The castle has been set upon by a giant.
No.
I warned you. Why didn't you do something?
I don't make policy. I just carry it out.
And I warned you that you can't count on the royal family to solve your problem.
All right. I think it best we return to the village right now.
I wouldn't be in such a hurry if I were you. Guess which path the giant took on his way to the castle.
What do you mean?
All that's left of my garden is a sack of beans. And there isn't much left of your house either.
I was told giants really strike the same house twice.
I heard that. Oh. I don't know.
Oh, there. Did you feel the trembling out there?
Consensus among them as to what course of action to take.
Put a spell on her. I no longer have my powers. If I did, you think I'd be standing here with all you? No, we have to give her someone.
Who?
The steward. It's in his line of duty to sacrifice his
daughter. Don't be ridiculous. I'm not giving up my life for anyone.
Ah, I'm waiting.
You must understand that these were not people familiar with making choices. Their past experiences in the woods had in no way prepared them to deal with a force this great.
Would you like a blind girl instead?
face.
We're not miserable.
What are you talking about?
Down, everybody. She does not want a woman. All right, fine. Then what do you suggest? I don't.
I'm still waiting.
It is interesting to examine the moral question at issue here. The finality of stories such as these dictates that... What? Oh, no, sorry. I tell the story. I'm not part of it.
That's right. Not one of us.
Always on the outside.
But that's my role, don't you understand? There must always be someone on the outside.
You're going to be on the inside now.
You are making a big mistake.
Oh, nonsense.
You need an objective observer to pass the story along.
Some of us don't like the way you've been telling it.
If you drag me into this mess, you'll never know how your story ends. You'll be lost.
Oh, he's right. He's the only one that knows the story.
You think it would be fun when you have to tell it yourselves? Think of your baby.
Yes, he's all right, just leave him alone. Oh, you put that away, young man.
Yes, you don't want to live in a world of chaos, do you?
What? Here! Oh, no, no!
This is not the lad!
Don't run! Why did you push him into her arms?
You wanted to get rid of him, too.
Well, we might have thought of something else.
Oh, if it were up to you, a decision would never be made.
Well, not if he's gone. We'll never know what will happen next.
Don't say that. We'll manage. No.
First I search among your motherland.
No, I have a child.
Boy!
We had no food to eat, and he sold his beloved cow in exchange for magic beans. If anyone is to be punished, it's the man that made that exchange.
He was your responsibility. Now I must punish him for his wrongs.
We've suffered too. You think it was a picnic, disposing of your husband's remains?
You are getting me angry.
What about our anger? What about our loss? Who has been flouncing through our people? You'll never find him.
Don't upset this.
You'll never find him.
Oh, I'm warning you.
Don't go back this instant. We'll get you for all that you've done. We'll go!
Where is your son? Is that him?
No. This is not the man.
The boy is hiding in the steeple tower.
Yes, if he is not, I will return and find you.
Wait! Wait, Mr. Hunt! No! Don't step on the...
Oh! She's in poor condition.
Wake up. Don't let him get checked.
We won't.
Promise me you won't let him be hurt as I stand here. A death's door.
I'll do all I can.
Promise!
All right, I promise.
No. Come away from there. You killed her.
I was thinking of the greater good. That's my job.
You know.
man can only crawl from something you love to something you lose.
Life was so steady, and now this. When are things going to return to normal?
We must be gone if we're to arrive before nightfall. Where are you going?
We're off to a hidden kingdom. We can't take everyone.
There's nowhere to hide.
You'll never get there. We have to stay here
and find our way out of this together.
Some people are cut out to battle giants and others are not. I don't have the constitution. And as long as I can be of no help, I'm going to hide. Now, everything will turn out fine in the end.
Not always.
I hope the giant stepped on them all.
You shouldn't say that. You were thinking the same thing.
Well, this is terrible. We just saw three people die.
Listen to it. Have you become so squeamish? How many wolves have you carved up?
A wolf's not the same.
Ask a wolf's mother.
Stop it.
I suggest that we find this boy and give her what she wants.
If we give the boy, she'll kill him too.
If we don't, she'll kill half the kingdom.
All right. One step at a time here. Now, maybe if the boy apologizes and makes amends.
Yes, he'll return the stolen gold.
But it's a very good idea.
Oh, my people are so blind! It's because of that boy that there's a giant in our land! Why don't you stand here talking about it? I'll find the boy. And I'll serve him to the giant for lunch.
Well? Are we going to let her feed him to the giant?
No.
I will have to find him first.
I'll go too.
No. You stay here with the baby.
We'll fan out. It will increase our chances of finding the boy.
But what if one of us were to get lost?
Well, we'll count our steps from right here. No, no, no. Not you. I need you to stay here and watch the baby. I do not want you roaming about the woods. You understand me? Good girl. Over there.
What? You would leave our child with her?
Yes. The baby's asleep. He will be safe with the girl.
No, but what if the giant were to return
no, no,
here?
No, the giant will not harm them. I know that.
How do you know?
I know.
No, but what if...
Oh, what if? Well, only a giant's foot stop your arguing.
She should be back by now.
She wouldn't get lost.
I'm sure she'll return.
No. I must go in search of her.
Well, we'll come too.
Oh, no, no. You stay here. I will count 100 paces, and I shall return soon.
Look who I found.
Please, don't let her get me to the giant.
It's not our fault. The giant wants you.
You're hurting me.
Let go of him. Leave him alone.
Where did you find this?
Where is my wife? She's dead. What?
I'm sorry, sir. I came upon her and she was under a tree.
He was sobbing over her like she was his own mother.
Oh, how awful. How could this happen? I should never have let her wander off alone.
I buried her in a footprint.
I should have insisted that she stay home.
Remorse will get you nowhere.
My wife is dead.
Wake up! People are dying all around you. You're not the only one to suffer a lot. And you're dead. You're dead. Now I say, let's get this boy to the giant before we're all so much dead.
You keep away from
this. This is no time to be soft-hearted. This boy is going to the giant. And dead. I am going
yes. to... He's the one to blame. It's because of you there's a giant in our midst and my wife is dead.
But it isn't my fault. Even those beans who persuaded me to trade away my cow for beans and the doubt. Those beans that have been no stalk to get up to the giants in the first place.
Wait a minute, magic beans for a cow so old that you had to tell a lie to sell it, which you told. Were they worthless beans? Were they oversold? Oh, and fellas who persuaded you to steal that gold.
It's your fault.
No. So it's your fault.
No.
Yes, it is.
It's not.
It's true.
Wait a minute, but I only sold the gold to get my cow back from you.
So it's your fault.
Yes.
No, it isn't. I'd have kept those beans, but our house was cursed. She made us get a cow to get the curse reversed.
It was father's fault that the curse got placed in the place got cursed in the first place.
Oh, then it's his fault.
So.
It was his fault.
No.
Yes, it is.
Wait a minute. Do I chop on the beanstalk like that's clear, but without any beanstalk, then what's queer is how the second giant gets down here in the first place, second place.
Yeah, how?
Well,
I did.
Thought you were.
No, it isn't, because I gave it to my wife.
Thought you
No, it isn't. Wait a minute, she exchanged that bean to obtain your shoes, so the one who knows what happened to the bean is you.
You mean that old bean that's your wife? Oh, dear, but I never knew, and so we do. Well, don't look here.
Not your fault, but I
didn't. See, it's her fault, and it isn't mine at all.
But what?
Well, if you hadn't gone back up again.
We were needy.
You were greedy. Did you need that hair?
But I got it for my mother.
It's her fault, then. It's the one about the harp in the third place.
The harp, yes.
I dared you to.
You dared me to. She said that I was scared. You dared me.
No, I didn't.
Oh, no.
Wait a minute. You hadn't dared him to.
And you had let the harp alone.
Well, if you hadn't thrown away the bean in the first place.
She was wrong in the first place.
It was
wrong.
It was wrong.
It was wrong. It was wrong. It was
wrong. It was wrong. It was
wrong. It was wrong. It was wrong.
It was wrong.
Shh.
It's the last midnight. It's the last wish. It's the last midnight. Soon it will be bones squished. Told a little lie, stole a little gold, broke a little vow. Did you? Had to get your prince, had to get your cow, had to get your wish, doesn't matter how. Anyway, it doesn't matter now. It's the last midnight. It's the bones flat. Nothing but a vast midnight. Everybody's smashed flat. Nothing we can do. Not exactly true. We can always give her boil. No, no, it wasn't the matter with the blame. Somebody to blame. Find if it's a thing you enjoy placing the blame. If that's the aim, give me the blame. Give me the boy.
No, no.
You're so nice. You're not good, you're not bad, you're just nice. I'm not good, I'm not nice, I'm just right. I'm the witch, you're the world. I'm the hitch, I'm what no one believes. I'm a witch. You're all liars and thieves, like his father, like his son will be too. Oh, why bother? You're just do what you do. It's the last midnight, so goodbye, oh. Coming at you fast midnight. Soon you'll see the sky fall. Here you're on a bean. Have another bean. Beans were made for making you rich. Planting an eyesore. Here you want some more. Listen to the roar. Giants by the floor. Where you can climb another witch. It's the last midnight. It's the last verse. Not before it's past midnight. I'm leaving you my last curse. I'm leaving you alone. You can tell the garden it's yours. Separate and alone. Everybody down on all fours. All right, mother, when lost the beans again. Punish me the way you did then. Give me claws and a hunch. Just away from this bunch. And the gloom and the doom and the boom.
Maybe I shouldn't have stolen from the giant.
Maybe I shouldn't have strayed from the path.
Maybe I shouldn't have...
Oh, we can't go on hiding him any longer. He must pay the price for his wrong.
Quick, tell me where he is.
Over there. See that tree where the birds are clustered? Jack is in that tree hiding.
Oh, thank you. Now justice will be served, and I shall be your king.
Thank you.
catch the potato.
Every notch was one straight rope.
The harder to wait, the better to hand.
The greater the good, the harder the blow.